can't still be working.
Yeah, well, there was a lot of filing to be done, you know.
Baloney. You know, Brad, if you wanted to find out what was happening at that family meeting, all you had to do was go yourself. You do live in that house, you know.
Yeah, well, I wasn't invited. Besides, I kind of wanted to hear what happened from you, so what happened?
Aren't you curious what the sirens were about?
Wait, I had the headphones on. What sirens? What happened?
Okay, well, let me put it this way, right? At this very moment, if there is any justice in the world, Katherine Bell might be dead as a doornail.
What do you mean Katherine might be dead?
She took a header down the staircase.
Whoa! Wait! From the beginning, please.
Okay, I get that, right? And they're in the middle of this big showdown in the living room. Well, I think it's a living room. How many rooms do they have in that place anyway?
Too many, go on.
Oh, okay. Katherine, who is really, she is really a horrible person. She's telling her almost husband that she is going to file bigamy charges against him if he doesn't divorce me and remarry her.
Ugh, he would never do that.
That's what he said. That's what I said, too. Absolutely no intention of rolling over and playing dead for that woman. Oh, I'm sorry. I guess that's a bad choice of words.
Wait a minute. Are you actually saying that you refuse to divorce Ned?
Absolutely. Oh, that would be letting the worm off way too easy. Anyway, listen. Once Katie got real clear on that score, she started throwing threats around at the entire family, including my aunt-in-law, the doctor, who happens to be recovering from cancer. The woman has no shame. Katherine, she has no shame.
Yeah, well, that's what I've been trying to tell you. So what happened next?
Oh, so then my so-called husband, right, he calls her bluff. He promises to have her arrested for some scam she pulled before she ever knew him.
Yeah.
And then he swore that he would make her the laughingstock of poor Charles. Which, by the way, suits me just fine because that's where I happen to be sitting right now and I don't like it
one
bit.
That is not true. Everyone who knows you loves you.
So when she fell?
What?
Oh, Katherine. Oh, okay, right. So she storms out of the room, right? And everybody follows her into, Oh, I'm having a mental block. What is that room called where you go in and out of the front door?
Foyer,
yes. So everybody follows her into the foyer, right? And she goes trouncing up the steps, screaming like Mrs. Michelli, who's the fishmonger's wife from back home, right? And she's trouncing up the steps, and then she just stops halfway up the steps, right? She just stops. She gets this, like weird look on her face, you know? And then all of a sudden, bang, right? She hits the deck. She's rolling down the stairs, ass over tea kettle. And let me tell you, that is some staircase to roll down, right? And so she's rolling down. She gets down to the bottom. She finally hits the bottom of the stairs and crack! Her head smacks against the marble. And she just lays there like a lux.
I can't believe I missed this.
What did you do?
Me?
Yeah. Oh, nothing, you know? My uncle-in-law, the doctor, anyway, he says that she's dead. But he starts doing CPR on her, and I guess he got a pulse. He's very good.
Yeah, he is.
And then my cousin-in-law, who wants to be a doctor, he called 911.
Jason.
Yeah. Then we just all stood around with our jaws hanging open, you know? The ambulance came and took her away, and we yapped about it for a while. And then I came back here.
Wait a minute. Are you saying she's really dead?
I have no idea. But one thing came through so loud and clear tonight. Ashton really, really, really can't stomach Katherine.
That's what I've been trying to tell you.
I don't even know what happened, really. I don't. But this is what I don't understand, okay? How can that dog marry a woman that he hates so much? I don't care what she was threatening to do to his family.
Lois, because he just did what he thought he had to do.
Oh, please, he must be one hell of an actor in order to fool Katherine into thinking that he liked her. Oh, yeah. Oh, really, he must be a really good actor.
No, because she didn't...
Lois, sweetheart.
Ned!
Lois!
No! Take your act on the road. It doesn't play here anymore.
Lois, come on. That wasn't very nice.
Oh, but ask me if I care.
Listen, I know he's really messed things up, but he... Well, he only did it because he really loves you.
She's right. She's absolutely right. Listen, if we could just have a rational, civilized conversation, a non-judgmental conversation, just the two of us...
No! Ow! It doesn't sound very rational to me.
Lois, open the window. My fingers, my thumb. Oh. Thank you. Oh, my God.
This guy cannot take a hit. Go home.
I am home.
Oh, well, then go to your room. Oh, Brenda, come on, I need your advice. Do we want to smash our fingers like that? I don't care.
It's all right, Annabelle. His bark is worse than his bite.
Well, I don't recommend that any of you put that to the test.
Father... I think we ought to have Lois at this meeting.
That's a great idea.
What for?
She was at the meeting with Katherine, too.
Well, you may be right. She is a member of this family now, whether she likes it or not. We should give her a taste of what it really means.
Well, that's one way to get her to divorce Ned. I'll call her.
Black and white is fine. Back to Ned.
I don't want to discuss him.
Doesn't the fact that he loves you to distraction mean anything to you?
It means that he didn't trust me enough to tell me the truth in the first place, which means I will never trust him again with anything, okay?
No, Lois, you have to just try and...
Leave me alone!
Oh, Lois, take it easy. It's AJ.
AJ, what do you want?
Well, it's not so much what I want. Grandfather requests your presence at a family meeting.
So what does that have to do with me?
Well, there's been a new development in the Katherine situation. Look, we consider you as much a part of the family as anyone else now. It seemed only right.
You're joking.
No, not at all.
So what, is she dead or something?
Well, not that I know of. Listen, we're going to hold up the meeting till you get here. Have you seen Ned?
Yeah, he's around.
Yeah, well, you better tell Ned to come along, too. Grandfather wants him. I'll see you in a few minutes, all right?
All right.
Save it, okay? Your family wants us up at the house for some kind of powwow. While we are on our way there, I do not want you to speak, touch, or try to make any contact with me in any way, shape, or form. Is that clear?
Mm-hmm. Oh. Okay, I'd say this is progress.
The hospital ran tests on Katherine before the surgery, and they found a potentially lethal combination of prescription drugs in her system. It appears that someone was trying to poison her.
Katherine was a junkie.
No such luck.
I spoke to a personal physician. She has no history of chemical dependency or drug abuse.
What sort of drugs?
A combination of digoxin, which is your heart medicine, and quinyl barbitone.
Which I take for pain.
Are you missing
it? Everybody
shut up!
What? Lois has something to say.
Are you suggesting that somebody in this house tried to poison Katherine?
No. I'm suggesting that somebody in this room tried to poison her.
Grandfather, that's a heavy-duty accusation.
So is murder.
Attempted murder.
When will this family learn that you don't solve problems by killing them? It merely exacerbates matters.
Don't you start on Ray Conway again.
Why not? It was that murder that brought Katherine in our midst to begin with.
Accidental murder.
You must qualify that, dear. He's still dead.
Could we resist laying all of this at Alan's feet? What's done is done.
She shouldn't get excited, you know. You really, you should not get excited.
Lois is right. Everyone, please, just calm down.
You know, frankly, Ned, you seem to have the strongest motive.
What?
Yes.
I got rid of her by having her investigated.
Excuse me, but I got rid of her by proving she wasn't even really married to you in the first place.
Lois has a good point right there.
Shut up, AJ.
The fact remains that someone was trying to do away with the woman. Now, while I might agree with the sentiment, I will never condone it. So, whoever's responsible, I demand that you step forward right this moment.
Don't look at me.
Oh, Jason, don't be silly. You'd never be a suspect.
I think this whole thing has Edward's touch about it.
Oh, nonsense, Monica.
Grandfather doesn't murder people. He prefers to torture them slowly.
Kind of smells like a Tracy to me.
Are you out of your mind?
Well, who's Tracy?
My mother.
Oh, the same mother who was a roadie for your band when you were in high school and who went to Woodstock?
What? Woodstock?
That's good, Ned.
Oh, Ned, what a tangled web we weave.
I'll explain later. AJ, you know damn well my mother had nothing to do with this.
Tell me she's not locked away in the attic or something.
Oh, like Jane Eyre. How quaint.
No, she's not, but it's a fun idea.
You know, if anything, this sounds like Alan's handiwork. He does have a history.
If I hear Ray Conway's name one more time, I'm going to scream.
Okay. How about Rick Weber?
Who's he?
Monica's lover.
Former lover, and Alan didn't kill him. He tried to, but as far as I know, he is alive and well.
Dad tried to drop a building on top of him.
Oh, AJ, don't be unkind. Alan's paid dearly for this, and let bygones be bygones.
Why don't I get that?
Who are these people? And how did you get related to them?
They're not so bad when you get to know them, dear.
Yes, they are. And now you understand why I tried to keep this family away from you.
Oh, Ned, give me a break. The idea of you being above all of this is really going to be the biggest joke of all. I'm still not hearing what I want to hear. Now, somebody will take the responsibility for this debacle.
Oh, I have heard of it. Everybody, cool it.
Watch.
We have company.
Lovely surprise.
Hello, Lila.
Yes.
Mr. Donnelly, how are you?
Sean, may I offer you a drink?
No, thank you, Edward.
How is Tiff?
Oh, she's fine. Sends her love to you.
Yes, I really enjoyed our visit.
Hey, what about that baseball strike? I really, really messed up the season, didn't it?
Actually, I'm a football fan, Alan. Edward,
why don't you have a seat?
I'd prefer to have a word alone with you.
Oh, hey, you know, don't look at me. I came in at halftime.
You'll all excuse us?
Yes, we will.
Wow, that's just great, Ned. Now you've done it.
I didn't do anything.
Oh, come on!
I didn't!
How did Sean hear about this?
Children, don't panic. Alan, you said that Steve Hardy wouldn't file a report until morning.
That's what he told me.
Well, then who called the police?
Well, I bet it wasn't the murderer, folks. Attempted murderer.
Okay, Alan, you have made your point on
you
that
You shouldn't
one.
Yeah, keep but... this at a low roar. You know,
sweetheart, stay out of this. I'll handle it. Everybody keep your voices down.
Well, I'm going to tell you all something. I, for one, resent that Grandfather assumes any of us killed Katherine.
I can't really blame him. All of us wanted her out of our lives.
Yeah, but not like this. I'm afraid I don't have an alibi.
Oh, they couldn't have met you, Jason.
Wow, there's your alibi, Jason. Innocence by virtue.
Shut up, AJ.
Okay, that is enough, both of you.
Methinks AJ doth protest too much.
Let me tell you something, Ned. If I had tried to kill Katherine, I wouldn't have botched it. There wouldn't have been anything attempted about it.
Is that a dig at your father?
Well, if the shoe fits.
Ned, let us discuss who had the strongest motive.
No, let us discuss Victor Jerome instead. I know.
He was already dead. I just tried to hide his body.
Who is Victor Jerome?
Not to worry, dear. Alan didn't murder him.
What must Thanksgiving dinner be like in this house?
Oh, it's a riot. Everyone argues over who gets to carve up the turkey.
I tried to warn you, sweetheart.
Well, at least I have an excuse. I'm too busy throwing up with chemo to worry about anybody's demise but my own.
Oh.
Is he gone?
For the moment.
How on earth did Sean find out about this already?
He didn't. He was here investigating the Bradley Ward murders.
Oh, great. Who is Bradley Ward, and what did you do to him, Alan?
That one we're clean on, sweetheart.
Would you stop calling me that?
All right. Can we get back to the business at hand? Whoever tried to kill Katherine, it's time to step forward.
Oh, come on.
Oh, ridiculous.
Father,
stop it.
Really? Well, there's one county that hasn't been heard from yet.
Excuse me?
Oh, Grandfather, don't you dare.
It really makes very good sense, and we don't even know her after all. And if there was ever anyone with a motive for a crime of passion, it has to be Lois. It's okay, dear. You can trust us.
I don't think so. You know, Mr. Q, I was taught to respect my elders, but, you know, I gotta tell you, you're a nutcase. You are all certifiable. Oh, no.
It all has to come out eventually. Now, you tell us the truth now, and we'll stand behind you later on.
I'm blowing this popsicle stand.
Lois. Yes. Thank you. What the hell were you thinking of?
What nobody else around here is considering, this family. And if it steps on your love life, Ned, that's just too bad. But we've got a murder on our hands.
Attempted murder!
You call it what you will! The fact remains that if we don't discover the culprit, you can be damn sure that the police will.